after going like to high school, here's where I work and where I live, a small city named Cheongju in Korea. And before getting into some ideas, I want to share two pictures with you. When we think about traditional education or studying in situation, we can think of this kind of classroom with some isolation, and students get easily bored, and they will have their dreams in class. And sometimes students are, or most of the time students are disengaged and disconnected with each other, and they sometimes fall asleep because our lessons are not interesting that much. So, as a teacher, we always try to make our lessons meaningful and interesting for our students, right? So, what I've been struggling for the last couple of years as a teacher was to make my students participate more actively as an active participant, not a passive consumer of education, and to make them collaborate with each other for group projects or something, and to be motivated to learn more, and to be engaged, and to lead their learning as an agent, not a passive learner. So this is the ideal classroom that I've been looking for, and I think you are the same idea with me. So then, how can we make our lessons meaningful? Because we are in the fourth industrial revolution now, we have come up with some new educational goals, such as before getting into the educational goals, let me frame this term first. The term VUCA is brought from the Cold War, and this is the acronym of volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. Because the world is changing at a rapid rate, we cannot really expect what's going to happen in the future. So most of the things are, many things are very uncertain, and they are ambiguous, and they are not simple. Then how can we adapt ourselves in a new world? I found flexibility is the key thing that we have to have as a core competence. Then to develop such kind of competences inside of our students and ourselves, there are a lot of things that we have to do. Then here are some of our new educational goals, including distance learning, personalized learning, multicultural learning, educational training, and sensitivity training as well, and blended learning, where our students are enjoying learning. Then, so those are the goals. Then how can we achieve those goals? That was my intention. With first industrial revolution, we come up with some new and emerging trends in education. We're going to look at three different parts. The first one is curriculum. We have national curriculum, and as a teacher, I followed the national curriculum, but now it's not enough because as the world is changing at a rapid rate, what we are doing in classroom should be changed. So, diversification and flexibility in curriculum implementation is necessary. And we call this curriculum reconstruction. So, as a teacher in the classroom, not just following the national curriculum as it is, modifying some parts, considering my students' level, their needs, and their interests, those are necessary. And new methods should they come with the new curriculum. And ICT in front of this is when those are what we are searching for. And to achieve those goals, we need some special setting, like ICT friendly, and where distance learning is possible. So the curriculum method and setting, those are now changing. And as education changes, the way our students look changes as well. So even when I was younger, I had to bring all the books every day to school and to home. And it was not easy. But as education changes, the students look different. So now, in many countries, they bring their laptop instead of having books. They use digital books, even in some countries, in Korea as well. So, in this new world, what we need has been changed. And because I'm an English teacher, I brought some ideas in EFT, but I was wondering how many of you are language teachers or English teachers? Nice to meet you. Some of you, not many. So, instead of sharing my experiences in English education, let me share how I used mobile technology in my classrooms today. But the most important thing is, so in Korea we've tried many, many things to make quality education possible. And then what we found was we need a qualified teacher. Then who are qualified teachers? What kind of qualities should teacher have? That was the question.
In estos momentos.
And then the next question was, profesora coreana está dando su disertación. So we put them competence now, and those are some competences, global competences that we want our students to have in the future. For example,